Yo, what's up, brothers and sisters, but mostly brothers. This is Julius Logan, but for the sake of the comment section, or if you send me a personal message, or if you see me on the street, you can call me Jules. I find that acceptable. Yo, brothers, I feel you. You know I feel you. All the stuff that you're going through, most of that shit I'm going through too. You know what I mean? You know, I feel you. I understand where you're coming from, you know. Ever since we came here, the odds have been stacked against us. It's been forces trying to wipe us out, forces working against us, you know, from the gate. I understand all of these things. But we doing a lot of shit to try to destroy ourselves. And I ain't going to get into all the dumb shit like the killing and no shit like that. I'm talking about your seed now, your bloodline, your children, our fucking future. Let me tell you why my head is here. All right, so I'm at the barbershop, all right? I'm getting the shape up. Well, I'm about to. I'm sitting there waiting now. And ahead of me, it's two little kids getting their haircut. Well, one and one waiting. And they got their mother there, a young mother. And then they got the grandmother, you know. And she a young grandmother. So they sitting there, you know. My barber trying to cut the little kid's hair. Little bastard won't stop crying. Alright, I didn't mean to call him a little bastard. But the fact is a fact. Alright, little bastard won't stop crying. You know, he's bitching up. And, you know, the family's around. And these are little kids. I ain't gonna lie. I mean, I ain't good with kid ages. But they couldn't walk or talk well. I mean, they could walk, but couldn't talk that well. I guess, I don't know, one or under, anyhow. So he's trying to cut the dude's hair, and the little kid won't stop crying, you know, they babying him and whatnot. And what really struck me as profound, for one thing, to get almost off subject real quick, is Shorty, the mother, had to keep telling the little baby, the youngest one, had to keep reminding her that she was the mother. The baby kept referring to the grandmother as the mother, which goes to show you she looks at her own mother more like a sister, which goes to show you who's really raising the kid. That says a lot of things. That's a whole other subject. In any event, what got to me was, I'm thinking, where's the dude in this situation? You know what I mean? All right, you know, it could be in a number of things. You know, if you locked up, if you're dead, well, all right, bro, naturally you can't be there. But for the most part, I'm saying we as men, we really got to take a larger part and children's lives, you know, especially your own children, especially your fucking seed, your bloodline. You know, I mean, they need that discipline, they need that balance of having both their parents around, or at least involved as much as they can, you know, in their life. I mean, look at who you got raising your kid. You know, I mean, maybe Shorty got a job, you know, maybe she going to school, maybe she got a job and she going to school, you know, she running around trying to see what you doing, saying she don't need a man, looking for a man, you know, all kinds of shit she could be involved with. And during this, your seed is just, you know, dragging around behind her, picking up all kinds of baggage that, you know, this kid is going to have to deal with for the rest of their life. You know, I'm not saying that all single women are bad mothers, but shit, some of them are. Some of them are, you know, you really got to pay attention. You know, first of all, you should have been, like I always say, you should have been more selective, you know, who the fuck you was sleeping with. You know, bottom line, you got to know where babies come from if you're fucking, in any event. But you just want to be involved in this kid's life because you never know how they're going to be raised. Now, I'm not naive. I understand, you know, that women can be hard to deal with, straight up, you know, especially baby mothers. I mean, they can be real difficult to deal with. But straight up, brother, I don't really care if your baby's mother is a badger. A fucking badger. If you met her in Canada or whatever, and somehow y'all two came together, and she is just the most difficult fucking thing in the world to deal with, still, that's your seed. That's your future. You know what I mean? That's your child. You gotta be. You try to get sole custody. You do what you gotta do, but you gotta stay involved in their life. You know, you never know what's happening. I think a lot of these kids growing up, you know, that are fucked up in the head, is because what happens to you when you're a young child really, really dictates the person you become in the future. And that's why our young children, we have to show them the dynamics of relationships, how men and women get along, how you're supposed to be in a relationship, so when they grow up, they know how to deal with the opposite sex themselves. That's why families are so fucked up now, and a prescription, if you ask me, which you didn't, for black people, for a lot of the problems that we're facing, would be strong families. Now, I understand people come from great families and they still fuck things up anyway. But let's not handicap our children. Let's not handicap our fucking future. You know, we all really need each other really bad now. And it's a point in history where we can get a lot of things done, a whole lot of things done. There's a lot of opportunities out there for us if we go out there and fucking get them. And that's what we need. And maybe you made some fucked up decisions in your life. Well, this is the kind of information you want to impart to that child. So as a man, we really, really got to be involved in our children's life. And you might say, oh, well, fuck you, Jules. You're a fucking hypocrite. You don't got no kids. All right, yes, this is the truth. However, you know, I got a lot of nephews and nieces and cousins and all kinds of family and whatnot. Like I said, we're a big family. I mentor. You know, I try to do my part because We all gotta do our fucking part. That's the thing. We all gotta do our fucking part. That's the only way we're gonna get anywhere. Is it? You know what? This shit should be common sense. All right, man. That's all I gotta say. I'll get it, Joe. Peace.